Alright. Reading Rainbow, episode 90, Berlioz, the Bear. Okay then. Zoom, zoom, bzzz. Zoom, zoom, bzzz. Berlioz had been practicing for weeks, and now, just when the orchestra was going to play in the village square for a gala ball, a strange buzz was coming from his double bass. Why now? Berlioz said to himself. The musicians arrived with their instruments. As Berlioz watched them climb aboard the bandwagon, all he could think about was his buzzing bass. What if his bass buzzed during the ball? What if the dancers stopped dancing and laughed at him? Zoom, zoom. Buzz, zoom, zoom, buzz. He imagined. Berlioz picked up the reins and clucked to the mule. Off they went down the road. He was so worried that he didn't see a hole in the road ahead. Suddenly, the wagon lurched to a stop. The front wheel was stuck in the hole. The mule took one look back, sat down, and yawned. Oh dear, said Berlioz. What can we do? We'll be late for the ball. I'll help you, said a rooster, who was passing by on his way to the ball. The rooster pulled and pulled, but the mule stayed put. A tabby, who had been watching from the top of a fence, spoke up smugly. That isn't a job for a featherweight, he purred. I'll do it for you. And he took hold of the rope and pulled, but the mule wouldn't move. Everyone, put on your concert tailcoats, so we'll be ready to start as soon as we get there. Just then, a schnauzer came trotting over the hill. He took one look at the cat and sniffed. A furball like you can't pull a bandwagon. Let me have that rope. He panted and pulled, but the wagon stayed in the hole. Along came a prancing billy goat. He looked at the schnauzer and snorted. Move over, squirt, and let me do it. I'll have this wagon out in no time. The billy goat strained forward, but to his surprise, he got nowhere. He checked his pocket watch. There wasn't much time left. Allow me, said a plow horse coming across the field. This will be easy. I spend my days pulling, but even the plow horse couldn't move the mule. Berlioz tugged at his ears. He looked around and saw a large ox lumbering toward them. You're saved, roared the ox. He twisted the rope around his horns and gave a mighty tug. The animals held their breaths, but the mule wouldn't budge. The clock on the tower started to chime 8. Oh no! Berlioz shouted. In desperation, he pulled his bow across the strings. And to his dismay, he heard zoom, zoom, bzzz, bzzz. All the musicians turned to look at the buzzing double bass. Out of the bass shot a very angry bee. It had been disturbed once too often. The first thing it saw as it flew out of the bass was the mule's hindquarters. Bzzz. With one giant sting, the bee made the mule jump to his feet and pull the bandwagon of musicians out of the hole, down the road and into the village square before the bells had stopped chiming. The audience roared. "What an entrance!" they cried, and the orchestra, already dressed and tuned, began to play. Zoom, 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 zoom. It was hard to say who had more fun at the ball, the musicians or the dancers. Berlioz had never played better.
"Encore, Berlioz! Encore!"
Berlioz came forward.
"Thank you all, and this evening I would like to dedicate our encore to the buzzing bee!"
The end.